goes for my.
Sis, hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first.
Gotta fix that calendar I have. That's March July 15th. Because since there's no more you.
Good evening, good evening, good evening, and welcome to your favorite evening talk show, The Dish. And happy Valentine's Day, everybody. My name is Edma Ohimalawe, your host, and we are coming to you live from our MX24 studios at Silicon Square, East Legon, Accra. So, if you're watching us for the very first time, the show is called The Dish. Get to know, okay? And it's being divided into two segments. So our very first segment is called Let's Talk, where my guests and I review all the biggest trending issues from social events to sports, politics, entertainment, you name it. We talk about it right here on The Dish. We take a youthful, fun, but stern perspective on the matter. And then our second segment is called Tête-à-tête, meaning head-to-head in French. But then it's just basically one-on-one. In English at the same time. It doesn't make sense, but it doesn't matter. But this is when I have a one-on-one session with a celebrity guest of the day. But let me remind you that this is an interactive show, so do send in your comments, reactions, and opinions to all the stories that we cover right here on the show, to all our social media platforms at MX24GH with the hashtag, do not forget the hashtag, The Dish on MX24. But join us online as well. We are currently streaming on Facebook, Twitter, and on YouTube at MX24GH. Today is our Val's Day special. As you can see, I am looking the part, and my guests are also looking the part. Guys, you need to see my ladies right here. But coming up is Let's Talk, so do stay with us. And once again, happy Valentine's Day.
We'll be right back.
Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music.
Issues. So from social event to sports, politics, entertainment, showbiz, you name it, we touch down on all of these issues. But you can also join us online and share your opinions on our WhatsApp number at 0550-331-511. Or you can just, you know, share your thoughts on our social media platforms at MX24GH with the hashtag The Dish on MX24. So, as you already know, because if you've been watching us since last week, you should know that, you know, I don't do this alone. I have two beautiful, listen, I'm crying, but two beautiful young ladies to join me on this conversation today. And I have the one and only Alexandra Aqua, who is not new to this show. But then we have a new face today, and she goes by the name of Vanessa Gyan. Hey, darling.
Welcome.
You're absolutely welcome. So welcome on The Dish.
Thank you.
Alexandra, you're an old member, no, so I can't even say welcome on The Dish. But okay, so we are going to talk about a few topics that's been trending over the weekend and today as well. So the first one that we're going to talk about is sports. I don't know if any of you are into sports. But don't worry, we'll get into that. But we're going to talk about Chelsea winning the FIFA Club World Cup. Is that your team?
Yes.
Oh my God. Okay, don't worry. So we'll talk. Do you know what? You know, usually what I do is I mention all the topics that we talk about, and then we talk about them one by one. But I think today I'm just going to start with the very first one, and then eventually as time goes on, as the show goes on, we touch down on all the other topics. So today we're going to talk about Chelsea. So over the weekend, Chelsea won the FIFA Club World Cup, beating Palmeiras, which I think I pronounced right, I'm not sure, but they beat them 2-1. I watched highlights of the show. But are you guys into football? Vanessa just like,
when I see people on Twitter going crazy, I'm like, okay, time for me to mute everyone because I'm clueless. I'm literally clueless.
But do you have like a specific team that you support or?
No.
No, you don't? But okay,
for me, football is more American football.
Okay,
you know, soccer, football, I never got into it.
So you watch American football, but you don't watch soccer, it's like football. Oh, okay, that's interesting. You're literally like the first Ghanaian girl who I've heard
really?
Say that, yeah. Because usually, I feel like in this part of the world, they follow football as in soccer more.
Maybe because I was in New York. So
makes sense.
Yeah.
Americano, we have them among us. But okay, so your team won.
Chelsea.
Well done.
Since 2006, you've been very loyal.
Yes, I mean you guys did well. It's your very first time winning that cup, and I think at it stands now, you guys have actually lifted every single cup there is when it comes to club football. So, well done. I mean, well done, well done, well done, well done. I'm jealous, but well done. I'm a Man U fan. I'm a Manchester United fan. So, I used to be a Chelsea fan, actually.
So, what happened?
I don't know. I think because my dad was a Chelsea fan. So, the whole household was literally like, Chelsea. And then I went to uni. I left home. I went to uni and I was like, this team cry, let me just move to the Red Devils. And now I'm not disappointed.
Blue magic
I'm,
is I'm raining.
I'm still happy that I'm at Manchester, but, you know, we just need to do a bit better, you know. But anyway, so when it comes to football, I'm going to try and talk to Alex more because, obviously, it's a team. But would you say that football is something that maybe ladies should watch more, or is just like a male thing to do? Because, you know, you hear these, you know, memes, or you read these memes on social media, and it's like, when your girl watches football with you, she's the one, kind of thing. You know, you see those things on social media, and it's like, really, do we need to watch football to be the one?
No.
But do you agree with those things?
No. I think some people are, you know, more interested in football than others.
Yeah.
Case in point. Exactly. And I think it's fine. I don't think we should make it a gender thing.
Yeah. What about you, Vanessa? Do you agree?
I don't think it has to be a gender thing. If you like it, you like it. If you don't, you don't.
Yeah.
Because there's men that don't watch football. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Also, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah. I agree. Okay, so now let's move on to our next topic. So we're talking about events. So now over the weekend, we had two phenomenal Vals Day themed concerts from both Kwabna Kwabna on Saturday 12th, which was called Love Night. And on the 13th of February, Akwaba also had his that was called Shades of Love. Interesting. But we have videos for you to watch from both concerts, just highlights from both concerts. So let's watch and then after we talk about it. Lante with a beautiful song. But guys, we have another beautiful lady who has just joined us in studio, and she goes by the name of Adwoa. Hey, beautiful. So we'll get into why Adwoa is actually here later during the conversation, but she has a special purpose for being here today, and she's going to give us some tips as well. So ladies and gentlemen, please do stay tuned for that. But anyway, so before we went on we played Knii Lante's video. We spoke about Kwabna Kwabna and Akwaba's concert over the weekend, which is becoming a thing. You know, people are really, I wouldn't say capitalize it, capitalizing or using Val's Day as a commercial way to make money, but is a theme that around the world, people, if you have a business, you know that you have to get with a theme and make sure that, you know, you get some money out of it, because it is what it is. But then people will also say that maybe we're also losing the essence of Val's Day. And if we know the actual true meaning of what Val's Day is and where it originated from, then we are sort of like diverting from what it is to what it is now. But let's firstly talk about Kwabna Kwabna. He was on the show last week. I got the opportunity to actually interview him last week, and it was great. And one thing that I asked him was about his transition from, you know, the music that he used to do before to what he does now. I mean, his sounds is completely different. His look, brand, everything is completely different from the Kwabna Kwabna, the asshole that we used to know, you know, and now the sound that he makes. So let's talk about his growth. If you've seen his new music, let's talk about his growth and how he used to be back in the days and how he is now. Alex, I'm looking at you.
Well, I've been a big fan since he dropped Asshole with Kunti Hine.
Yeah.
And he went quiet for a bit, and it kind of picked up again. Mm-hmm. I'm not really sure what he's got going on, but I think what I would say is that there's definitely something original about him.
Yeah.
And him as a person.
As a person, yeah.
And even from his clothing, fabric, you know, he's going with this Afrocentric theme.
Absolutely.
And I think it's really interesting. Mm-hmm. And I think that not only is it going to, I think for Ghana, we are shifting slowly to embracing all of that. Well, that's my perspective. I could be wrong. But I think internationally, I think he's positioning himself really nicely, and he should keep going. I think it's a very sweet sound that he's coming up with, and he should keep
it up. What about you, Vanessa?
I think he always stays true to himself as he's growing. Mm-hmm. He's not afraid of the person he's becoming, the artist that he's becoming, which is great, because many artists are afraid. You know, they're afraid to rebrand or to even grow. They stay in like the same place. So it's really impressive to see him growing, and he's a legend.
Yes,
and I feel like he's not even like I don't feel like he's not respected even enough. He is a legend.
That's actually what I said to him when I was interviewing
And I don't even think he, some people, they don't even know it themselves. Do you know, like, he, I don't think he knows how much of a legend he is, and the power that he has when it comes to music and what he's created, you know. And I'm supporting him. I love
I love his music too. But Adwoa, so now let's come to Akwaba, okay? And over the years, I've loved his music. I mean, his dad is one of those high life legends, and he's walked in his footsteps, and I love the fact that he's doing what his dad was doing, which is high life. He hasn't diverted to, you know, Afrobeat or Afropop, Afro Soul. I don't know, there's so many names right now, but you know, he's sticking to high life. And I love his new song with Sina Soul. It's literally like one of my favorite songs. So let's also talk about his growth in the industry, and if you like any of his songs, which one would it be?
I think his song that comes to mind is it I Love You? That's what I know him for. And I feel like, just like Kwabna Kwabna, he's also stuck. He's also stuck to his roots. He's not tried to become what he's not, which is good as a musician. So Akwaba, I feel like, is my guy, you know?
I totally understand what you mean. Okay, so now let's talk about when it comes to their brands. Would you say that both of them have similar brands, or like quite different? I mean, one is high life and the other one is just, you know, like Afro Soul. He calls it Afro Soul. Like, his new sound is actually called Afro Soul. So would you say that they have like similar brands, or is quite different, but they're still like reaching the same audience? Because, you know, Kwabna Kwabna also sings in Chi. And I was telling him how he makes his Chi sound so romantic. Because, like, you know, and he was like, yeah, do you know what? Our language, the Akan language itself, can sound a bit aggressive. But he's made it in a way that when he sings it, it sounds romantic. And I even told him that, okay, so this is, you know, between us ladies and whoever is watching. So One time I went to a show, and it was a late night show, and they asked me, oh, Ahima, so if you're making love with your partner, would you want them to speak Chi or English? And I was like, oh, English. What is Chi? Like, who wants to be hearing, no, stick to English, you know. But then I made that joke, and he was like, no, do you know what, there's so many other ways that you can speak in Chi and still sound romantic. But both of them speak in Chi in their songs. But would you say that with that is still enough for them to maybe go international?
Absolutely. Mm. Absolutely. I mean, we've had other people sing in their native South Sea Soul.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sing in their native language.
Angela Kujo and won a Grammy.
Burna Boy.
Exactly.
You know.
Yeah.
Honestly, if they're listening and they can hear me, stick to what you know.
Mm.
You know, stick. I don't think their sounds are the same, but I definitely think that they are reaching the same target.
Yeah.
You know, what Kwabna Kwabna gives you in totality is an experience through his music. Whether you're seeing a video or you're seeing a visual or you're just listening to the song, he gives you an experience. And I think that that's like another layer that he's reintroduced that I think will really work for him and cross like over.
Okay.
So he should keep doing
that. Do you agree?
Yeah, I agree with that 100%. I feel like there's space for both of them. So not both of them necessarily doing the same thing, just being true to who they are and, like, you know, sticking to what they know and reinventing as they go along and growing.
Yeah, so, I like that word, reinventing. Oh, what about you, Vanessa?
I agree with both the ladies, but I do feel like Akwaba is so underrated.
He's so underrated.
Like, he should be so much bigger.
But so what would you say is the issue? Is it the branding,
Ghana,
the marketing?
You really have to pay for some odd reason. I don't know why it's so difficult in Ghana, whether you have talent or not, to just break through. Like, you hit and bam, you're going. There's this thing, it's like you really have to pay your dues. And I think he's in the process of paying his dues.
But he's been in the system for so
long. Like, I feel like in Ghana, the average pay your dues time is 10 years.
That's so long. Because then, you know, somebody will come in the industry and just blow.
Exactly.
So then you're now wondering, okay, what are they doing differently?
I think maybe marketing.
Yeah, marketing. Yeah, and advertising of maybe their craft.
Yeah.
Or?
I think it's just timing and opportunity.
Because we can use somebody like, let's say, Jackie as an example.
Right.
Jackie came out with a first song, Forever, and that was it. You know, it blew on the internet, it went viral on the internet, and I think the internet also plays a huge role in making your song, you know, be heard across borders. And, you know, it blew, and now she's been doing really well consistently.
Well, so, I guess her strategy, I mean, at the time she was in campus, so she had that crowd, which is a very influential crowd.
True.
And people who had just left, people who were in there, who were just coming in. So she really appealed to the very, like, young people. When these guys came on the scene, they were already very mature. They were already catering to the more mature age groups. So I think that probably is also because we are online. We are on, we are on Spotify. We're on YouTube.
Exactly.
We're streaming and stuff like that. So I think probably that helped her.
Okay, but before we basically wrap up the conversation, I want to jump to our next topic before we wrap up the conversation with two videos by Akwaba and Kwabna Kwabna. So now let's talk about Vows Day. Today is Valentine's Day. Valentine is here. Where is your boyfriend? Okay, so we were singing that song last week on the show.
Yes.
Valentine's Day is finally here. Guys, how do you feel about Vows Day? Vanessa?
It's like a regular day, you know.
Is it a regular day because you didn't celebrate it?
No, I feel like I'm loved every single day.
Like, by the boo?
So, Val's Day is like a bonus.
Val's Day is like
out of the question.
Exactly, thank you.
So, Val's Day is like a bonus.
Yeah.
You know, but I think people are just like crazy right now about like Val's Day. Twitter was like, who's going to get this gift? What's going to get this? Everyone has to share what they're getting. And I'm like, it's not that serious.
It's
like, we don't have to always show everything, you know. But it's a day of love, whether it's like friendship or relationship. It's a day to just celebrate love.
Alexandra,
you,
Valentine is here. How did you celebrate it? How do you feel about the day itself?
Well, like Vanessa said, it was a very regular day. I mean,
just work.
Yeah, it was just work. But I would say that I get the hype, and I think we should allow people to just like take one day out of the year and just enjoy being in love and being with their lovers. Like, I haven't enjoyed that in a while, but I love it for people, you know. And I think that it's absolutely fine to take one day and spoil your partner or, you know, go all out and show it off. I don't think that you should be pressured if you don't have it.
Exactly.
But if you do and you want, I mean, just this one day that you can do it and everybody's doing it and you're just doing it, like, go all out and do it.
Absolutely. So, and what are your thoughts on that, Zoa?
I think there's an important part of Valentine's Day that people are forgetting, which is the self-love.
Thank you. I mean, that was the thing that we're going to talk about next, but go ahead.
I think that with everything that's happening, you know, we tend to, you know, go hard at everything we're doing.
Yeah.
So we shouldn't think of Valentine's Day as another day for showing love to your significant other. We should start thinking of it as a day to also show love to yourself.
Okay. So I spoke about this on the morning show today. I had a great conversation with Elikem do you know the name? We had Cookie on the show as well, and we had Jeffrey Notte as well on the show, and we spoke about self-love on Valentine's Day. And one comment that Jeffrey made was that, do you know what? You have the whole year, January to January, to actually show yourself some love. But Valentine's Day is that one day that you can show other people love, except from yourself. So if you want to use that day to self-reflect or self-love yourself, I mean, you can do that. There's nothing wrong with that. But then you have the whole year to also do that, which he made a solid point. And Elikem slightly disagreed with him. You know, he was saying that at the end of the day, it's also a thing. Like you just mentioned, Adwoa, listen, what if throughout the whole year or the whole time that you've celebrated Valentine's Day is always been with somebody, is always you showing love to somebody, but then today you've said to yourself, do you know what? Let me show myself love. Let me buy the bag that I've always wanted to buy for myself. Let me buy the shoes that I've always wanted to buy for myself. Maybe throughout the year, I wouldn't have time to buy the shoe. I wouldn't have the money because I'm spending money on other things. So let me dedicate this one day to buy something for myself. I mean, it can be... Look at Alex's face. She's like,
all the time. Yeah.
I agree with that because I feel like also during the year, you're also always giving.
Yeah.
People's birthdays, people's
bridal
showers,
you know.
You know, so that day could be that day for you. Valentine's Day could be that one day, essentially,
I mean,
that, you know.
I agree if you're single. You know, so obviously then you need to
but
be
even
that
if
person.
You're single, I mean, you have your friends and
like yesterday we did Valentine's Day, you know, so you still celebrate. You're always giving. We're always giving. We need to, like, you know,
So basically, I'm sure we all know where this whole thing. We know why this day even exists in the first place. Yeah. We know Saint Valentine's and what happened to him when it comes to his love and how the emperor didn't want anybody to get married. And I bring this different stories, but this is the one that I know because Elikem told me this morning and I didn't know before that. But so apparently there was an emperor who banned everybody from getting married. So Saint Valentine's was actually marrying people behind closed doors in secret. Yeah. So he got caught. Got imprisoned and then fell in love with a prisoner's daughter. So eventually, on the day that he got executed, he wrote like a letter to her and then signed "From your Valentine." Okay, so it was like a sweet thing to do because they fell in love, blah blah, this and that. But so that's basically why this day is celebrated, because of love, and it's to represent the love that he showed to others by marrying people who could not get married. So it's like he was holding the fort for love. Really, he was like a representation of love. So now my question again is, have we lost the essence of it? Because you mentioned how Twitter was going crazy today, for example, people showing their gift, you know, your girlfriends will call you, hey, what did your boyfriend get you today? You say he got me, you know, he got me, I don't know, a card. And it will not be, hey, he doesn't love you, or he got you a card, really, my one bought me this. So it's like we've made a whole big deal out of Valentine's Day, especially when you're in a couple. It's like my couple is determined by what happens on Valentine's Day.
But that's wrong.
Exactly. But it happens and it's been happening. I know people who have broken up because maybe their partners, they didn't celebrate Valentine's Day with them or got them a gift or anything like that. And they were like, do you know what? I don't want to be with you anymore because you didn't get me a gift. So this is how significant this day is to people and this is what it means to people. But would you think that it's too much for people to even base their relationship on just one day?
Definitely too much.
Because then what is your relationship about? Mm-hmm. Is it just about the gifts? Is it just about the show and tell?
Yeah.
Meaning there's no surface to your, there's no substance to your relationship, because it's always about what am I getting? What am I getting? Oh, today I can't get you something, so.
You know, Vanessa, I also feel like, you know, I mean, life happens. Mm-hmm. There's so many things going on. But I think I would appreciate it if, like, my partner on this day, and myself also for him, I take the trouble, make the effort to go, you know, to show something.
I'm not saying don't
but
give me
what
a
I
gift.
Don't, what I disagree, what I disagree is a point you made, the show and tell, because I feel like now it's less about reaffirming and validating your relationship to getting external approval from people that don't even matter. And I think that's where the conversation is kind of swinging, and that's what I disagree with. So the real genuine ones don't even want to have anything to do with this anymore.
I actually agree with Vanessa. I think that, you know, Valentine's Day these days has it's just become very commercialized, right? And there's relationships go through phases, right? When you're with someone, there's a period they have. There's a period they don't have. So what happens when, you know, you are in that season when your partner doesn't have? So I think all this fuss is better spent focusing on, like, the quality of your relationship and improving the quality of your relationship, other than, you know, the material things. Because the material things come and go.
Absolutely. But anyways, guys, I'm sure you can appreciate a very cute Valentine's Day setup. Oh, because I am. And our special guest today, Adwoa, Cocor. Did I pronounce that right?
Cocor.
She is basically the head.
The lead creative director.
The lead creative director of the Picnic Station. Exactly. And she is responsible for this beautiful setup today. And she's going to basically take us through simple yet very romantic ways of putting together some nice setup for a date night on a budget, because that needs to be included. So now, Adwoa, so if, let's say, I want to take my partner, not even just on Val's Day, but I want to take my partner on a picnic somewhere in this hot weather, and you know, I need, like, a setup, what are the things that maybe I should bring with me?
So number one is a mat, definitely, you, because you don't want to get dirty, or you know, so you get a mat. And then you don't necessarily need a table, because bottom line is, these tables, it's not everybody who can get one within short notice. So you can improvise with, let's say, a basket, turn it around, and then lay.
Oh, that's a very good idea.
Yeah,
I never thought of that.
And then you can either use the bottom, but, you know, sometimes the bottom is dirty. So just lay something over it, like a small cloth, or, you know, anything you have. Just lay that over it, and then use that as your eating surface. You also need like a cooler, so you can keep your drinks cool, your fruits, you know, chilled. And then you also definitely need a cup or a glass. Usually I would say get a cup, that, because, you know, because the glass are breakable. So they can easily be broken. And then you can get, like, little tea light candles if it's in the evening. You can get little tea light candles.
Do you go for a picnic in the evening?
Romantic.
Yeah.
Have you been to Accra by night?
Oh, yeah. But if I go to the beach and I have the beach and I have dinner at the beach, is that a picnic? Do you know what my concept of a picnic is?
Daytime,
hot sun. In a park, grass, or something.
So that is the history of picnicking.
Okay.
So it started as a daytime thing by the English.
Okay.
But with time, it's evolved. So now you can't, you don't even, you can't, I mean, you can do daytime picnics, but it's evolved beyond the daytime.
So, you can have, you can,
yes. And even, what's it called? Dawn picnics is a thing.
Wow.
Right? Yeah. So.
By the beach. If one man water comes in, by, you know, say your house people.
So by the beach is also a thing. In the park is also a thing. In your backyard is also a thing. I always say that the only thing that stops you from having a picnic is your mindset. Your imagination can always run wild.
Amazing.
You know. Yes, it's your creativity.
Amazing.
How about, like, the car, you know, because I've seen it in movies.
Yes, the car
where,
picnic.
You know,
the movie in a car park or something. Yes.
But anyways, girls, thank you so much for joining me on Let's Talk today, right here on The Dish. Vanessa John, Alexandra Aqua, and Adra Cocor. Thank you so much for joining me on The Dish today for Let's Talk. It's been a pleasure, our Valentine's Day special. But coming up next is tete-a-tete, and we have somebody very special coming up. So stay with us.
I thought it was sold out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Very much sold out.
Look, you're wasting my time. I obeyed your meaning.
I even got you something even better.
Who could be better than a Kwabwa ticket?
Hold your words.
Free Benz.
Dad, let the Benz go. It's not happening.
Mom, Dad, I'd like you to be my friend.
Look.
What's happening?
Sit up.
Okay.
Send me five on team mafia. Found a chimmy sway. Sesame, I go soon. I'm a sad Jimmy. Fence, she a big guy. The mammy, Denny, be here. Namidia, never. So yeah, I'm you. Let's put our phones away and go don't just hold me tight, light up the fire. Fire, what you see so well. They come as soon as in the day. Namidia, never. Oh, so yeah, I'm you. Jimmy,
MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that find your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24.
Play football, but I touch down everywhere.
We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music.
But today, our main guest for the show is a man with many talent. He's been known for his incredible voice as an Afro-pop and reggae artist, but also known for his career as a medical doctor. He's been very vocal on many health issues in the country sometimes. That's also even well represented in his music. We'll get to know more about him and also premiere his very new song. Oh, I'm excited. But before we get into the conversation, please, let's watch, you know, one song that we all got to love, and it's called Someone You Love.
Touch your back, scar. Let's do something bad. See, we already crossed the line, baby. My you can crush. Dada, don't check our pass. Why? One we can crush. Dada, don't check our pass.
MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Slow down. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to your favorite artists. The best new music first. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music.
And you can't stop wishing she's back at home. Don't try to fight it, don't deny it. You've been crying, who's guilty? Gonna be the one for saying sorry. When you someone, you'll be there, you'll be there. When you love someone, this crazy fool will be there. When you love someone, you're still there, you're still there. Love forgives through the good and the bad, one life to live, live. That's what we promise, share with me. Sweeter than honey, I'm watching your feet, holding this beat of love when we meet. Ain't it so sweet? But he's not there, nothing they write. When he come there, everything they tight. When you look,
MX24 is home to your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Slow down. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that define your era. MX24. We love music. MX24 is home to you.
Say the one and only.
Thanks. Thank you so much, man.
You're welcome. Welcome to the dish.
Thank you.
It's great to have
your favorite artists. Hear the best new music first. Slow down. Catch exclusive interviews and jam to the hits that the...
But we just watch a throwback song right now. You know, when how do you feel about watching that old video?
The part I remember be some part where the director talks to my lips be too dry, so they put lip gloss. Anytime that part they come catch, And the press say people not go see him.
But, did see? But to be honest, me, I haven't noticed.
Oh, child, I shouldn't have said it.
No, I'll go and watch it again. But thank you, man. And welcome on the show.
Thank you.
But my first question is, today is Val's Day, of course. And one of the things that I've noticed when it comes to your song and the kind of songs that you write and produce is mainly focused on love. Is there a particular reason why love is one of the main reasons why you do your songs?
Well, when I started, mm-hmm. you know, first singing, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. there were artists like Luther Vandross,
yes.
who I was trying to imitate, ah. you know, so... And most of the artists I used to try to sing, like, were the crooners, like those who sing.
Yes, yeah.
And usually they sing about love.
Absolutely.
So,
yeah, they did.
I mean, they sort of ushered me into that corridor.
But you had a different sound.
Yeah, different. With time, you become who you are. You know what I mean? But when you start, at first you learn by imitating this person. There was a time I was even trying to imitate Michael Jackson.
Hey, how did that go?
It's not easy.
That's amazing. So now I want to also know you've spoken about the influence of love when it comes to your music as well. But now let's talk about one part of the intro that I read, which, you know, took me aback a bit when it comes to your career as a medical doctor. Mm-hmm. And let's talk about that and coexisting it with being an artist. How do you do both of it?
Okay, so I you know, I've tried to analyze it myself and make sense of the whole thing. And the conclusion I've finally come to is that I think I'm interested in healing. And I found out that from the time I was a kid, you know, I like to, like, make peace amongst people. Even though me myself...
You don't be peacemaker like that.
But I like to make peace, you know, and I don't like place where too much friction day.
Yeah,
exactly,
chaos,
you know. So I was into the business of healing, you know. And then, you know, I started to write songs. This was before medical school.
Yeah.
And then I found out that, it's got to do with love. And when you sing, people feel, they feel okay, you know what I mean? People will go call you, tell you, say, they had this problem with their girl, but after listening to that song, you know, the proposal went well. And then,
hey,
you know,
I've heard
that thing many times.
That's
you know
amazing.
This song, Baby Take Good Care?
Yes!
I've heard so many stories about that song.
But people use it to propose it.
I tell you.
If you're watching,
something bad. But, you know, so, and then the medicine too, I found out that, okay, it's all got to do with the healing thing.
Yes,
so it's all like healing, you know, and without healing.
They're all connected.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Without healing, society can't go on, communities can't go on, because you need to heal society to keep regenerating. As you heal life, you burn more life. You'll be healthy, then you go born and bring forth more life.
Yeah.
You understand? It'd be so annoying. You did society inside and you try to heal. Mm-hmm. As you heal society, society we're healing no day inside there, it go burn up, you know. So that is it. I think it's just total healing, you know, that I'm into. And if there's any other form of healing also, I go like Jan.
Hey,
that
amazing.
You for bringing me inside. Yeah, man.
But today is Val's Day.
Yeah.
Okay. And you just spoke about healing. And I think that one way that you can heal also is through love.
Yes.
I really do believe that. Yes. But what are your thoughts on today, you know, being Val's Day?
I didn't really used to celebrate Valentine's Day. I don't really have my own
understandings
and things about it and how it came about and things like that. But with time, I've learned to just accept that Chalet society too, with time, into the doing your own thing. And even you come to meet a society and this is what you do to celebrate love, I think it's only fair that, you know, even if, you see, like, for example, Christmas. There's talk that Christmas Day not be the day where they born Christ.
True.
I accept that.
True.
But, you know, we have to choose a day. And if society has chosen this day to remember him, I go take remember him in that way. You understand? So, it'd be so. If Valentine's Day, and even people, they use them for negative, or it was born out of negative, me, I go see the positive side of it, you understand? And encourage people, make them fall in love. Because love be the thing you for fall into, not be any fight or anything.
Absolutely, you totally understand? Agree with you.
Yeah,
but
man.
Then when it comes to love, how well would you say that it's, or how much would you say that it's important for you to self-love yourself when it comes to self-love, actually? Yeah, that's the question I wanted to ask.
Yeah, self-love is always important. But, you know, if you read any of, any of the... sacraments that have been written, or any of the patch, the parchments, let me put it that way, that have been written by any of the sages or those who, you know, those with their mind open, where they write things, make we follow.
Yeah.
All of them, they talk, say, if I love the other person first. You understand? And there must be something in that teaching.
But
you
know, learning,
if you love yourself.
Yeah, if but you if love, you love somebody first and you don't love yourself first, how are you now supposed to know how to love the next person? Because you don't even know how to love yourself.
No, but you know, these are very abstract terms. Me, I come born and not say, okay, if you cut me, you go pay me and I go defend myself and that be my love of myself. Mm. But what I go really like to focus on is to build love between members of society. Mm. Because see, there's so much that's happening, so much negative. Mm-hmm. I mean, you see people begging in the streets, you see people don't have water, you know, and it's all because of lack of love. Mm-hmm. If we get love, like this country in resources, if the resources come, we go take do something, make it benefit the people themselves. Mm. Now, somebody, because it not be love, way be greed and things like that. We all want to accumulate the money into our own corners. And you know, the wealth of this country is finite. The more people accumulate, the less that is left for you to also enjoy.
Yeah.
You understand? So we can't just say that, oh, as far as they, let's make our money. The poor, they should find their level.
Yeah.
The more we make our money, the less they become, you know, they have something to survive on. So I think that, Charlie, let's look at the love of the other person first, feel his pain. You understand?
Ourselves.
And when you do that, it actually bounces back to you.
I totally agree.
You understand?
I totally agree with you. Okay, so now let's quickly talk about your new song, which I'm very excited about. What inspired it?
Well, there was this day I was in a studio. You know, I'd been sent the rhythm.
Yes.
It was actually a rhythm which had been sent to me by Comanti Music.
Yes.
You know, Ja Beloved is an artist who also works closely with Comanti Music, and he invited me onto the rhythm. So I got the rhythm, I was listening to it, and I started writing. I wrote about three very conscious songs, but you know, I listened, as I started listening, I was like, no, Charlie, this is not the time. People won't free up them. It was getting towards Christmas, anyway, it was in December. I was like, Charlie, people won't free them, their minds and happiness, you know. The conscious there, we've talked from beginning of the year till now. So now, make me free, you know. So I decided, okay, I was fooling around with choruses. And then and then I just happened to sing, let's do something bad, because I was feeling very lazy that day. You know, so I just, let's do something bad. Oh, and I see, actually, no, the thing he learned for the thing side nice. Okay, make a harmonize and pack with the thing.
And then fire.
I say, Kai.
Amazing. But before we wrap up the conversation, congratulations. You've officially been nominated for 3 music awards as well
as
the Reggae Dancehall Act of the Year, which is an amazing nomination. And we wish you all the best for it.
Thank you.
But any final words for anybody watching?
2022, we have a lot in store.
Yes,
and all fans of Knii, Lante should watch out, because this year is going to be like a year you've never seen.
Amazing.
You're going to see sides of me you've never seen before. You know, and this time I free up enough time.
Yes.
You know, I have enough time to do music and time to do medicine.
Yeah.
And it's just going to be something else.
Amazing. And quickly, if anybody wants to listen to your song, connect with you, what do they go to?
It's Knii Lante, KNIILANTE, on all the platforms.
Oh, okay. And on all the streamings as well. Well, there you
have
it.
If you get my number 2, go for a call.
Hey, that one you put out there.
Let's do something bad.
Let's do something bad. Amazing.
Yeah,
but guys, thank you very much for sticking with us. That's about it for the dish today. It's been another amazing and fun episode. And it's going to be like that throughout the whole week, from Monday to Thursday, from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. right here on MF24. So do you make sure that you stay with us, okay? But it's now time for me to say thank you to everybody who came on Love Nest, and it's our very amazing show that we basically celebrate love every single year. Like I said, last year was amazing, and this year we did it even bigger. So do make sure that you stay tuned for Love Next, and it's coming up right after this show, okay, right here on MX24. So do stay tuned and share your opinions on our Twitter page as well, you know, hashtag Love Next on MX24. But once again, my name is Edma Ohimalawe, at Edma Lawe, E-D-M-A-L-A-W-E-R, on all social media platforms. Connect with me. Happy birthday, guys. Good evening. Bye-bye. Take me in your love.